Greetings everyone, we will continue our discussion on information retrieval systems. In the previous sessions, we have started about what is a signature file and how to create a signature file. And we have looked about what is a sequential signature file and what are the various classifications of that particular sequential signature file. In this session, we will be looking about those classifications and we will be learning about one of that particular classification techniques, that is compression techniques. So initially we will be looking about what are the compression techniques you have, then we will be looking about the various types of compression techniques in detail, that is the bit block compression and the variable bit block compression and the performance comparison of these compression techniques with your basic sequential signature file. So in the as you have known already, the sequential signature file is about your taking a particular document and breaking down that particular document into blocks, and we are going to have these blocks. Inside the block will be having a set of words. For each and every word will be creating a bit pattern, that is ones and zeros, and we will be having two design patterns, that is F, which will be the size of your bit pattern, and M, which will be the number of bits which will be set in the pattern, and we will be representing each and every word with a bit pattern. And among those bit patterns, how many bits should be set will be decided by your M, and the maximum length, that is the length of your complete bit pattern, will be decided by your design pattern F, and we will be getting for each and every word one bit pattern. Those bit patterns will be hard to get your block pattern, that is block signature. So all the block signatures will be stored in a sequential fashion, that is in a row wise manner, to get your complete sequential signature file. That will be your basic sequential signature file. So some additional methods have been proposed to improve these, the performance of your sequential signature file. One of the particular methods is your compression techniques. So what is this compression technique? These methods create sparse document signatures on purpose and compress them before storing them sequentially. So whatever you have created in the sequential signature file will be containing bit patterns, that is will be having ones and zeros. So in a compression techniques, what you basically do is you are going to create the same sequential signature file, but we are going to make that particular matrix as a sparse matrix, or you are going to have these ones and zeros in a more sparse manner, that is you will be having more number of zeros than ones. Okay, you will be storing, or you will be creating your particular matrix in such a manner that you will be having more number of zeros and less number of ones. So we'll be on purpose we'll be creating the sparse matrix before storing them sequentially. Okay, we'll be creating a sparse matrix and we'll before storing them in sequential fashion. When compression is applied, the best value for your M will be 1. That is, M is your total number of bits set. Okay, the total number of bits set in your particular bit pattern will be decided by your M. So for compression techniques, it is better to go for a value of M is equals to 1. That is, whatever may be the size of your particular bit pattern, whether your F value might be 12 or 14. So based upon your F value, you have to take your M value as 1. That is, only 1 bit will be set as 1. So in such a manner, you will be having large number of zeros and less number of ones, and will be having the word pattern as a sparse pattern. Okay, so these things will be used. The resulting methods achieve better false drop probability than your sequential signature file for the same space overhead. So we'll be having a similar space overhead, that is we'll be having the same space complexity for both the methods, but we'll be getting a better false drop probability, that is we'll be getting a better output from your particular search of your sequential signature file. So the compression version will be giving you better results compared to your sequential signature file. So the idea in these methods is we use a bit vector of b bits and we hash each word into one bit position which are set to 1. Okay, what you are going to take is we'll be having the bit vector. So here we have considered the total number of bits you are having in your particular bit pattern as B. In the previous examples, you have considered the same bit pattern as F, that is the total number of bits you are having as a part of this bit pattern. We can either represent by using F or by using B. So whatever may be the bit pattern you are having, the total number of bits will be represented by B, and whatever your word may be, we hash each word into one bit position which are set to 1. Okay, whatever if your bit pattern is 16 bits, among these 16 bits we are going to map this particular each and every word into only one bit position. Among the 16 positions, we are going to map your particular word into one position. Since your M value will be treated as 1, why? Because only one bit has to be set. So we are going to take your M value as 1 in your compression methods. So we are going to map each and every word into one bit pattern positions. Okay, one bit position in your complete bit pattern. So for example, if you see, so the resulting bit vector will be sparse and therefore it can be compressed easily. So this is an example of your bit patterns. That is, you are having a word called as data. This is a unique word which can be present in one of the blocks. Okay, remember, this particular, whatever you are doing is an extension of your sequential signature file. So your sequential signature file is an uncompressed version. Whatever you are seeing here is a compressed version of your sequential signature file. So you have to remember that basically this will also will be containing whatever file you are having. You are going to break it down into blocks, and each block will be having some set of words like this. Okay, this may be one block words. So whatever may be the block words, so each and every block word you are having, one block word will be mapped to one bit position in your bit pattern. Okay, one block word will be mapped to one bit position in your bit pattern. If you see here, we are having total of 20 bits. Okay, we are having total of 20 bits, that is B is equals to 20 bits, or if you can have the same different representation, B or F, it will be equals to 20 bits you are having, and your M value is 1, that is total number of bits that are set in each and every word pattern is 1. So if you see, the data word is mapped to or hashed to this particular bit position. Okay. Next, your base word, the word, whatever the word is mapped to this particular bit position, and management word is mapped to this particular position, and system word is mapped to this position. So each and every word in your block will be mapped to only one bit position in your bit pattern. So at the max you can be having, if you are taking M value as 1, at the max you can be having how many? For your F value is equals to 20, in a block you must be having at the max 20 different words. Okay, 20 unique words you can have per block. So the 20 words will be mapped to 20 different positions, but will not be taking those many words per block. Why? Because whatever the block signature you are trying to get here also should be a sparse block, sparse pattern. Okay, so if you see the block signature, we are going to get the block signature just like in your sequential signature file. We are going to do OR operation on all these things. Okay, we are going to perform the OR operation on all these individual bit patterns in the positions, and we are going to get one in this particular positions where you are having one. Okay, so those positions you are having one, you will be getting one in your block signatures. So we'll be calculating all these block signatures in this manner for each and every block in your file, and all those block signatures will be placed in a sequential fashion, that is row by row in your sequential signature file, to get your complete block signature. So this will be the basic thing. What you are doing is you are taking a larger F value, that is you are using larger F value, that is in a sequential signature file, your F value is whatever we have taken example as some 14 or 16. Here we have taken your F value as 20, that is you are going to take larger number of bits to represent your word, and among these words we are going to set only one bit as 1, that is you are going to take M value is equals to 1, that is you are going to map each and every word into only one bit position. Okay. So like this, what you are doing is you are deliberately creating a sparse version of your bit pattern. By that you are getting a sparse version of your block signature. So each and every time you are taking this thing to make it a sparse version. So the space wise, once after getting the particular sparse version, what you have to do is you have to do the compression part. So you have to deliberately create the sparse vectors, whatever you have created. Those sparse vectors have to be deliberately created, and after that you have to perform the compression part. So we are having various methods to perform this compression. So the simplest method you are having is the run length encoding. Okay, what is this run length encoding is? The space, whatever you are having, that the space based version compression method is based on run length encoding. Among these compression techniques you are having, the best space overhead method is your run length encoding. So we'll be getting two more other methods. Among these methods, your run length encoding will provide better space overhead. However, the searching will be very much slow in this particular run length encoding. So if you see an example regarding this run length encoding and how you are going to represent your compressed data. So for example, you are having your original data in this manner, that is, you'll be having a sequence of zeros and ones. Okay, these zeros and ones might be your block signatures. So if you are taking this as the block signature, so what you are going to do is you are going to convert this block signature into a compressed version. So the compressed version, what you are doing is you have to take. So what is the thing you are having? 14 zeros. After that you are having one value. Next you are having 4 zeros and 1. After that you are having another 1. That is 0 zeros and you are having 1. After that you are having 12 zeros. Okay. So this thing will be represented in this manner. So first you are going to represent the 14 value. Next you are going to represent the 4 value. Next you are going to represent the 0 value. Next, after that, you are representing the 12 value. That is, you are representing the total number of zeros present between the each and every data item you are having. So we will be having binary bit pattern. So the block signature will be a binary bit pattern. You are going to use that block signature to represent your compressed data. For example, in the previous thing, you are having 4 words in your particular block. So your block signature will be having 4 ones in your complete block signature. So out of the 20 words, will be having 4 words. If you go back for the example, so if you see your particular block signature, you are having 4 ones. So 4 ones, this will be the sparse version of your complete bit pattern. This you have to compress by using the run length encoding. So the compressed version will be, you are having 4 zeros at the start. Okay. Next you are having 1, after that you are having 2 zeros. Okay. Next you are having 4 and plus 2, 6 zeros. After that you are having 1 zero. After that you are having 3 zeros. So you are going to have a bit representation of these 5 values. That is, you will be representing the 4 value, that is 0, 1, double 0. You are going to represent your 2 value, 0, 0, 1, 0. You are going to represent your 6 value, that is 0, double 1, 0. And you are going to represent your 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. And you are going to represent your 3, 1, 1. So this will be the compressed version of your particular this data item. So as you can see, you are having large number of similar number of bit patterns here. But if you take less number of words in your particular block, we might be getting more compressed version. Okay, so I have represented by using 4 bits here. You can represent by using 3 bits only. Okay, you can represent by using 3 bits only. But you have to understand that whatever the sparse version you are having, you can compress into better version. That is, you can get a compressed bit pattern from your sparse version. So this compressed pattern will be providing you better results compared to your sequential signature. So I think you can understand by this time what is the run length encoding part. That is, you have to represent the number of zeros between the data items. So here you are having 14 zeros, you are going to represent the 14 value. Next you are having 4, you are going to represent the 4. Next you are having 0, you are going to represent the 0. Next you are having 12, you are going to represent the 12. Okay, like this, you have to tell the number of zeros which are present between the data values and the sparse values. Okay. So this is how you represent your length encoding, run length encoding. This run length encoding method is will provide better space overhead. That is, it will be taking less space, but it will be having whatever the search you are trying to do will take more time compared to your sequential signature file and other compressed versions. So the more important compressed versions you are having as a part of your sequential signature file is your bit block compression. So we'll be looking about the outline of the bit block compression, then we'll look at the example. So this method, whatever the bit block compression or BBC, so the BC method or the BC method we'll be calling it as, not the BBC, the BC method, bit block compression. So we'll be calling it as the BC method. This method accelerates the search by sacrificing some space compared to the run length encoding technique. So the run length encoding technique will be having a better space overhead, but whatever you are trying to do here is you are trying to accelerate the search. So in order to accelerate the search, we are going to remove some space overhead, that is, we are going to take more space compared to your run length encoding. So we will be taking more space in this version, but we will be accelerating our search. This compression method is based on bit blocks. We will be looking about what is a bit block, and we will be calling it as the BC method of the bit block compression method. Excuse me. To speed up the searching, the sparse vector is divided into group of consecutive bits or bit blocks. Excuse me. To speed up the search, the particular sparse vector is divided into groups of consecutive bits. That is, whatever the sparse vector you are having, that is based upon your size of your vector, that particular sparse vector will be broken down into bit vectors, consecutive bits. That is, we are going to break it down the complete 20, whatever you are having, 20 bits into bit vectors. Okay, so those consecutive bits will be calling it as bit blocks. Okay, those bit blocks will be encoded separately. So each bit block is encoded individually. We are going to take each and every bit block. That is, for example, if you are having some 20 different zeros, okay, we are going to break down your particular thing into bit blocks. That is, consecutive bit of bits will be treated as one bit block, and you are going to encode each and every bit block separately. So for each and every bit block, we create a signature. So for each and every bit block, that is, we are going to take separate bit blocks, and we are going to create signatures for each and every bit block of variable then, and consider at most 3 parts. So each and every, whatever the bit pattern you are having, you are going to convert it into some form. So we are going to break it down into bit patterns. Okay, then we are going to take the bit blocks and signature it separately. Those signatures will be created in various methods or various steps. We are going to look at those steps. So the bit block compression will be performed in 3 parts. The first part is, it is 1 bit long, and it indicates whether there are any ones in the bit block or the bit block is empty or not. Okay, so if your particular bit block, whatever you are having, if there are any ones, okay, so this particular block has 1, so we will be making part 1 as 1. If your particular bit pattern or bit block doesn't have any ones, then we are going to make it as 0. This will be the part 1. So for each and every complete pattern, we are going to create your bit blocks, and for each and every block, we are going to create 3 parts. So the first part is whether your bit pattern has any ones or not. So the bit block has any ones or not. If there are ones, we are going to place it as 1. If there are no ones, we are going to place it as 0. So that is part 1. Part 2, it indicates the number of ones in the bit block. So how many number of ones you are having as a part of that particular bit block. So if you are having a bit pattern, a bit block is in this manner. Okay, if your bit block is having 4 bits and you are having a pattern in this manner, that is 1000, then you are going to place your part 2 as S minus 1 bits. That is, the total number of ones you are having in this bit pattern is, you are having how many patterns, you are having 1, so you are going to place the value as 0. For example, if your complete bit pattern is 1100, so in this bit pattern you are having 2 bits, so you are going to place your part 2 as
1.
You are going to place your part 2 as 1. So this is the part 2. So it indicates the number of 1s in the bit block. It consists of S minus 1 1s and terminating 0. So this is not the optional way to record the number of 1s. However, this is a representation is simple and it gives better results close to optimal. Okay. So this is how you will be having the representation, and that is how you create the part 2. And for each and every bit block, we will be having part 3. So it contains the offsets of the number of 1s, or it contains the offset of the 1s from the beginning of the bit block. So for each and every bit block, for example, if you are having 1001, so the bit position, that is where the particular 1 is present. That is, it is present in 0 position and it is present in 1, 2, 3, 3rd position. You have to place the particular offset of your particular 1. So these are the 3 parts for each and every bit pattern you are, or bit block you are having. So the first part 1 is whether you are having 1s and 0s or not. Sorry, whether you are having 1s in your bit pattern or not, or your bit block or not. So if you are having 1, 0, 0, 0, this is your bit block, and you are having another bit block as 0, 0, 0, 0. So this is one bit block, that is another bit block. Okay. So part 1 is about whether this particular bit block has 1s or not. So you are having 1 here, so we place part 1 as 1. And in this bit block you don't have any 1s, so this way you place it as 0. Next, part 2 is about how many 1s you are having in the particular pattern. So we are having 1. So if your S value, that is whatever value, S value, number of 1s is 1, then you are going to place part 2 as S minus 1. If you are having 2, you are going to place it as 1. If you are having 3 1s, you are going to place it as 2. Here you are having 1, so I am going to place it as 0. So the number of 1, that is, if you are having 1 1s, I am going to place S minus 1. So here you don't have any 1s, so there will be no representation actually, it will be 0. So you don't have any representation here. And the part 3, part 3 is about what is the offset of your particular 1 present. That is, what is the position of your 1 present in your bit pattern. So it is present in the 0th position. So I will place it as 0, 0. So this will be the part 1, part 2 and part 3. These parts will be used to create your complete signature. So how we will be looking at with an example. This is a sparse vector with a set of values, and this is a bit blocks we have created a bit block here, that is 4 zeros, 1 0 1 1, 4 zeros, 0 0 1 0, 1 triple 0. The sparse vector will be created by using whatever you have done in the previous thing, that is, you have deliberately created the sparse vector and you have got that particular sparse vector. From that you have to create your signature. So the first compression part is part 1. So part 1 is whether you are having 1s in your particular bit block or not. So there are no 1s, so I am placing it as 0. There are 1s, so I am placing it as 1. So there are no 1s, 0. There are 1s, 1. There are 1s, 1. So the part 1 is about whether your particular thing has 1s or not. Whether 1 or S, S or no. So S means you are going to place it as 1, no means you are going to place it as 0. Then part 2 is about how many number of 1s you are having. How many number of 1s? So there are no 1s, so don't place anything here. There are 2 1s. So 2 1s means you are going to place it as your value, that is 1, 0. Okay, so don't get confused by this one. You are going to place it as S minus 1 followed by your 0. Okay. Next, here you are having S minus 1, that is your S value is 2 here, that is you are having 2 1s. Next, instead of placing 2, I am going to place S minus 1 followed by 0. Next, I am having whatever, how many I am having? I am having 1 1s. So your S value is 1. So I am going to place S minus 1. S minus 1 means, that is 1 minus 1 means 0 followed by 0. Next, the same thing, S value is 1, that is total number of 1's is 1, and 1 minus 1 is 0 followed by 0. So the second part is counting the number of 1's and placing S minus 1 followed by a 0. Part 3 is about the offset of your particular offset, of that is the position of your 1's in your particular bit block. So if you see, in this particular bit block, 1 is present in the 0th position, so I am going to place it as 00. Next 1, that is, it is present in the 3rd position, so I am going to place it as 11. Next, if you go for your this particular, it is present in 0, 1, 2nd position, so I am going to place it as 10. Here it is present in the 0th position, I am going to place it as 00. So that is the part 3. So this is illustration of your complete bit compression method or bit block method with bit block size of B is equals to 4. So this will be, that is the bit block you are compared, for each and every bit block you have taken 4 bits. So this will be the fixed thing, that is you have taken your bit block size as 4, and each and every bit block is of size 4, and from that you are going to create these 3 parts. From these 3 parts you are going to create your signature. So the parts of the document signature are stored in the following manner. So from those parts you are going to take the parts, and those are stored in the following manner. The first part of all the bit block signatures are stored consecutively, then the second parts, and so on. So for each and every block, okay, so if you remember your sequential signature file, for each and every block, so this will be the division of your file into blocks. For each and every block you are going to create one block signature, okay, and from those block signatures we have to get the document signature or the file signature. In this particular bit block compression, what you are going to do is, you are going to create for each and every block part 1, part 2, part 3. So for each and every block you will be having 3 parts. What you are going to do is, you are going to place all the first parts, then you are going to place the second parts, after that the third parts. That is, these are the part 1's, these are the part 2, and you are going to place part 3 like this. So with the separator we are going to place all the parts in your particular bit block compression. So the complete example is in this manner. So you have taken your sparse vector, from that particular sparse vector you have created part 1, part 2 and part 3. So from those parts, if you see, part 1 I am going to place here 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1. This will be the part 1. Okay, next 1, 0, 0, 0. This is the part 2. And the remaining, whatever that is present in part 3, you are going to place here. Okay, so this is how you get your complete, okay, file signature from your basic sparse vector. So this complete method will be calling it as the bit block compression, where you are going to take your sparse vector, break it down into bit blocks. For each bit block you are going to calculate your parts, from those parts will be getting the compressed version of your complete signature. Actually this should be your signature. From this signature you are going to get this signature, the compressed signature. So when you compare your run length encoding with your bit block, will be having more number of values here, so the space overhead will be high. But when you try to search for a particular value in your bit block compression, will be getting a better result. Okay, that is about your bit block compression. The next, another thing is about, another method is your variable bit block compression. So in the previous bit block compression, you have taken B value or your bit block value as 4. That is, you are going to break down, you complete your sparse vector into 4 bits. That is 4 bits you are going to break down. We have taken a fixed bit vector. Okay, we have taken a fixed bit block. Instead of that, we can take a variable bit block and perform the compression process. The idea is to use different value for your bit block size. for each message according to the nature of bits set to 1 in your sparse vector. So what you are going to do is, we are going to first check the sparse vector. So we look at how many number of 1s that are set in that particular sparse vector. Based upon that particular number of 1s which are set, okay, we are going to take a different bit block size. Okay, your number of bits which are set will be denoted by W. Okay, number of bits which are set in your sparse vector will be denoted by W. So for each different value of W, we are going to give a different value of your bit block size. Okay, so when you are having less number of 1s, you can be giving a smaller bit block, larger bit block. When you are having a larger W value, you can be giving a smaller bit blocks. So based upon the number of bits which are set in your sparse vector, we can take a different bit block value. Okay, so in the previous example, we have taken a fixed bit block value, that is 3. But in this variable bit block compression, we are going to take different bit block sizes based upon the number of bits which are set in your sparse vector. The size of this sparse vector B is same for all the messages. So whatever the sparse vector you are going to get, it will be same for all the messages. But whatever the compressed version we are going to get, it will be different. So the idea is, so the W, whatever the W value, which will be the number of bits which are set in your original sparse vector, so that will be the W value. And for each and everything, you have to create your part 1, part 2, part 3. But what you are doing is, you have to take, when W is equals to 1, that is, the number of bits which are set in your sparse vector is only 1. Okay, that will be a smaller message than when you are comparing your W value is equal to 5 or 6. That is, where number of bits which are set will be 5. Okay, if you remember properly, while performing the bit compression, the sparse vector, whatever you are getting will be, so if you are having 20 bits, okay, if your number of bits which are set to 1, if your 4 means, if your number of bits in the block are set will be 4 means, if your W value will be 4 means, so the message whatever you are having will contain 4 different words. Okay, so whatever that is you are getting, that is, if your W value is small value, your message will be smaller. If your W value is a bigger value, you will be getting a larger message. So for a smaller value, you will be getting different sizes of your parts. First, we will be looking at the theoretical part. So the upper row corresponds to smaller messages with small W, while the lower rows correspond to larger messages with larger W values. Okay, the upper row has larger value of your B op, that is, if your W value is small, that is, the number of bits which are set will be small, that is, smaller values, when your M value is equals to 1, then you will be having larger values for your bit blocks. The bit block size will be larger. So instead of taking a fixed bit block, that is 4, we can take a piece of bigger bit block like 5 or 6. Okay. So when you are having 20 different bits, among these 20 bits, only one value will be set. Instead of taking bit block as 5, I can take the bit block as 10. So we will be getting 2 bit blocks, then we can consider the part 1, part 2 and part 3 for this particular 2 bit blocks. So it will be much easier for you when you compare this version with the fixed bit block version. In the fixed bit block version, whatever may be your message, whatever may be the number of bits which are set in the particular sparse vector, we are going to take each and every time the bit block as 4. Instead of 4, we are going to take a variable thing which will be dependent upon the size of, that is, W, which will be dependent upon the number of bits which are set in your particular sparse vector. So what is this is? So the larger value of your, when your W value is small, you are going to have larger bit block value. Fewer bit blocks, shorter part 1, Okay, so when you are having fewer bit blocks, then you will be having shorter part 1. The size of part 1 is the number of bit blocks, and the shortest part 2, and fewer but larger offsets in part 3. Okay, you should be getting by this time what is the meaning of this. If you see the example, if you take this sparse vector, I have taken the same example which for your fixed version. So here the fixed version or your bit block compression or your BC method, you have taken your whatever the bit block size as 4. You have taken your bit block size as 4. So as you see, you are having various number of bits. For example, if you are having the same value, if this is your sparse vector, or if this is your sparse vector which you are getting for a particular message, in this message, if you see, you are having less number of ones. Okay, in this message you are having a large number of ones, that is you are having 1, 2, 3, 4 ones. So you are having 4 ones here. Your W value will be 4 here. For this message, your W value will be 1. So when your W value is equals to 1 or your message is very small, at that time what you can do is, you can take a larger bit block. So instead of taking your bit block size as 4, I will take the bit block size as 10. Okay, I will take the bit block size as 10. Now you can create the bit blocks, that is you can create part 1, part 2, part 3. So part 1 will be just, you are having only 1 here. So part 1 will be 1. So you don't have any 1s. So the part 1 will be 0. And how many number of 1s you are having? You are having only 1s. So the part 2 will be 0, and you don't have 1, so you don't have part 2. The part 3 value, whatever you are having, that is the position of your part 1, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So you have to represent the 7. So by using whatever the value 6, so this will be the representation of 7. So the complete thing is, you have to have 1, 0. Next you are having 0 and 0, 1, 1, 1. So this will be the complete representation of your variable bit block compression when you take your bit block size as 10 for this particular message. So based upon the number of ones which are set in your sparse vector, if you take a variable bit block size, okay, then you will be having better values and better version of your complete sparse signature. Okay. So this is how we'll be having, for smaller values we'll be getting, for smaller messages we'll be having smaller part 1 and part 2 and bigger part 3, and for larger messages we'll be having bigger part 1, part 2 and proportional part 3. So this will be about your variable bit block compression and the performance comparisons with respect to space overhead. The two methods, that is your bit block compression and variable bit block compression, will require less space compared to your sequential signature file, but you'll be getting better false drop probability, and the response time is slightly lesser than the sequential signature file due to decreasing I/O requirements. That is, the results we are going to get faster in your compressed versions compared to your sequential signature. So this is about the complete methods about your bit block compressions. That is, you have seen about what is the compression method you are having, that is you are going to deliberately create a sparse vector. From that sparse vector you have to perform the compression. To perform the compression you are having three different methods, that is one is runtime, run length encoding, the second one is the bit block compression, and the third one is the variable bit block compression. So all these three methods can be used to create your signatures which will be having more space but faster retrieval or faster search for your particular signature files. And we'll be looking about the next version, that is vertical partitioning and horizontal partitioning of the methods, that is your signature file methods, in the next session. Thank you.